Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about what is area chart and stacked area chart and how to use it in Power BI. This is part of Visuals with Nags series. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. When to use this area chart and the stacked area chart? Basically, this is the area chart and this is the stacked area chart. And this area chart and stacked area chart can be used to analyze the trend over the time series. Like, and you might have asked me, like, the same thing was we can do it in the line chart. So what is the core difference we need to understand and between the line chart and area chart? That is the first thing we need to understand. Let's try to have the line chart first and let's see what it makes. Let's go for core measure. Now from this line chart, it is pretty clear that you can see the difference, right? The different lines, I mean to say, like, there is a trend, there is an increment trend, that is increased trend, the sales over July 2018, and it is declined now in Jan 2019. Then again you see the increasing trend, and that is a some it is remains stable. So this is the overall from the beginning till now, there is a increasing trend. Now the same thing can be applied, right? I will just take a copy of this chart instead of this. Okay, I have x-axis date and the sales amount. Instead of this, I will use the area chart. What it shows is, like, it is area below that line chart. Basically it is a line chart and you can see the area below this line chart. This shows the magnitude, how much it is more, right? I mean, when you see how much in the area level, you can see the magnitude of it, how much it has grown, right? That is the core difference. People wants to see as a magnitude difference, then they will go for this area chart. This is not only the thing, and when you have analyzing this chart against different category, right, there comes a huge difference. Now let us introduce one more category, like product category wise, in this line chart first. Okay, so this gives different lines for each category, right? Like when you see here, bikes, components, clothing and accessories, and comparing, you can able to quickly understand the bikes are having more data, that is it the line is at the top, okay, which indicates this is the bikes are the most selling item. When you have the same category wise split in your area chart, what it happens? So you see it comes under legend. Okay, so basically what happens from this bottom till this bottom, I mean from the top till this bottom, the entire area components contributes to bike. Even you see from here, maybe we can zoom in. So from the bottom of this axis, x-axis, till this line contributes to components. So the entire area is covered. When you say blue, it is not only from this green to here, it is from the top till the x-axis zero, till this value it has been populated. So this is the difference. Again, the core differences, you can see the magnitude of it. You can see the difference between these two charts. It's like, looks like a mountain, like as you can see the how much magnitude difference is that. In area chart, that is slightly, you cannot able to find this difference. So this is just a comparison and gives you the magnitude of the difference, magnitude of that particular category, which category is giving you more. Easily you can is able to identify. This is the core difference. Let us get rid of this line chart, because in order to understand area chart, I use the line chart for the comparison. Now let's have the area chart here. What is the, now it's the time for us to understand what is the stacked area chart. Let's try to copy this visual and paste it here at the bottom. I have this visual now with me. So let me choose the stacked area chart for this. Click on this visual and choose stacked area chart. The axis remains same. The x-axis is date and y-axis your sales amount, and in legend I have the category. So when I press stacked area chart, what happens now? You see here, as soon as I use the stacked area chart, each category stacked on top of it, right? The highest magnitude means which has a huge volume, or the more data, comes to the bottom. Okay, you see here the bikes one comes here. So from the bottom till this point it is bikes, and from this point, okay, like over here, from this point till this point, it is the components. Okay, that is the meaning of it. So that data values are stacked here. This is the core difference between your area chart and the stacked area chart. This doesn't make any sense if you remove the category in between both the charts. The stacked chart and your area chart remains same. Okay, when you have only you are measuring against only one measure, you are not adding any other dimension in the legend. So area chart and stacked area chart remain same when you have a measure and x-axis dimension. But as soon as you add any other dimension, then that makes a difference. Like stacked bar chart, each category sits on top of it, whereas in your category, in the area chart, it is overall value. From this point till x-axis 0 point, the entire value is covered. Okay, one more thing to highlight here is like the total value at the top. Let's go for July 2019. You can see from here, since it is stacked, when you see at this top, it will give you your total value. You can able to analyze or grasp the total value. It is around 14 million. Okay, the total value. Whereas here, same July 2019, the total value is, I mean, you can see here, it is not against your total value. It is only below the 12 million, which is meaning like the bikes starts from zero to total value here, whatever contributes to bike. So that is why it is not summing up. You cannot sum up. So this is another important difference you need to understand between stacked and the area chart. I hope you understand about area chart and stacked area chart, what are the core differences, and other properties are as usual. You can change the some settings and properties, background colors. These are common to any other charts. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.